Hi, my name is Julian. I'm a political science professor at Laurentian University here in Barrie. You want to hold that for me? Thank you. I don't know what to say. I'm very happy to see this. I moved here a couple of years ago, and I was astonished by the way this city was run, and I was astonished by the social problems I confronted here. I didn't think they really existed in a place with so much wealth. And what do I got to say today? We're part of a larger movement, okay? This is not just happening here. And this is what we're seeing today. We're seeing a growing movement with a great deal of consciousness, and it's not just about poor people, it's about everyone. We're living in a time now where you rent your carcass out for a wage. And the last time I checked, that was feudalism, okay? And this is what we need to do. We need to change the structures of our society about representation so that we're all represented equally. We don't live really right now in a very, very good democracy. It's just for the rich, it's not for us. And I would love to see this grow. There are many groups, and I put my hand out to the groups that would normally not be out here. Farmers groups, labor organizations. They should all be represented here today. So, I don't want to say much more. I do enough talking at my job about this. I would like to see this just spread, and I'd like to see it open up an invitation to everybody to come out here. Not just the young people, but everybody.
Andrew Miller.
Wow. So, this is phenomenal. I think everybody is very excited about the turnout today. We'll be ready to get our march on here in a second, but I'm just feeling so inspired for this town as well. Growing up here and seeing, to get this many folks out and starting to get involved. This is just the beginning. We all know this movement is growing and it's evolving. We have to stick with it, keep hopeful, and for what I see, it's going to be evolving into taking part in projects to benefit this community and to learn new skills, to grow food, to become a bit more self-sufficient, to opt out of the system in ways that the 99% are the ones that put the 1% in power just through supporting the system. So by we're all learning and finding ways on how we can opt out. And to me, just to be clear, I am not the organizer of Occupy Barrie. We all are.
There we go.
Even though the radio, I believe, is saying that right now, any media, we've all, Shane and Dave were on Rogers TV yesterday. We each did radio interviews. This is a leaderless movement, and we are all contributing. And we all have a role to play. So that's the beautiful thing with this. What I can say, I'm very excited to start changing the conversation to solutions as well, because that's something I've been very passionate about for years, is when you understand what has worked in the system thus far. We have had some wonderful technological improvements or inventions, things that make our lives better. Of course, now the way farming's going is set up with dirty fossil fuels, diesel power tractors, things like that. But what we have learned with mechanization is we can be more productive, we just have to do it in a better way. If we can use clean energy, if we can use renewables, electric vehicles, things like that. I'm really passionate about seeing how we can use technology to further this movement and create sustainability on a global scale. And understanding what we have, the tools that we have at our fingertips, there's no reason why everyone on the planet couldn't have the healthiest food possible.
For sure.
Healthy homes for everyone. Right now we have 1 billion people starving to death on this planet. So that is proof right now that the system is failing. So this is why I'm involved in Occupy Barrie and part of this movement. We have to understand the root cause of the problem, from my understanding, is the socioeconomic system. The system is producing what we're seeing now. The system produces
financial system.
All the money going to the top. Once you understand the mechanics of the fractional reserve lending system, how banks work, how money is produced, it's imaginary. It's not real, but it's causing so much suffering. And this is what we're all waking up to. And this is so inspiring. We're going to be doing lots of workshops down at Unity Market Monday nights. I know on the 5th of December, Carmina and the Zeitgeist Movement are going to do a talk on what that's all about as a possible solution. There's the beautiful thing is nobody here is saying this is the one solution. We all have to arrive at that decision, and this is why we work on consensus. But there's some amazing ideas brewing, and keep the hope alive, keep the faith alive, and thank you everyone for being here, and it is good to be alive.
Hello, Barry. Thank you so much for coming out. All of the community Hawkins. Together. This is fantastic. What's happening in the Occupy movement around the world is that people can sense when something is unfair, and they can sense when something is unjust, and that injustice, we're saying basically we're not going to take it anymore. We're coming together. And the root of so many of our problems, social problems, environmental problems, sustainability problems, are because of the economic injustice at the root. Because we have at the top a 1% class who are able to take huge amounts of things and then keep them. And that encourages them to take more, because every time they take something and they're allowed to keep it without being held to account, that encourages them to do it more. So they take more and they overconsume and they just eat up more of our planet. And the people at the bottom, the underclass, they have everything being taken from them, and they have nothing, and they have no security, which means they have to scrabble to grab whatever they can get, and their concern is just survival. And then in the middle, you have a middle class who are running on a constant treadmill because they're driven in two ways. One is they want to get to the top where they can keep everything, but they're afraid if they don't move fast enough, they'll fall to the bottom where they'll have nothing. And so this economic injustice causes everyone at every level to take more than they need. And if we can reform our system to have a just economy where you can't take anything, because if you take what is someone else's, it'll be taken back from you. You won't be allowed to keep it. If the 1% aren't allowed to keep the things that they take, there won't be any point in them taking too much anymore, because it goes back. And at the bottom, if the people who have nothing are assured that they will have healthy and safe housing, healthy, nutritious food, a good education, clothes on their back, they won't have to scrabble to do whatever a desperate person will do to support themselves. And the people in the middle won't be with this fear that they'll be left with nothing, and they won't have this ambition that they can take more and more, because they'll see the takers will not be the keepers. So together as a community, we need to come together, find this economic justice where everyone has their fair share, where no one is left with nothing, but also no one is given the power to take far more than they deserve. And I think this is the beginning of accomplishing that. I see people from all different groups and aspects of the community coming together and saying, we want to get away from this finders, keepers, take what I can kind of attitude. We want to have a human economic justice and work together and share a planet that's more than abundant enough for all of us. So it's fantastic to be starting that with Occupy and moving forward through Barry and the rest of the world. Congratulations.
This is Hunter.
Briefly thinking last night that I've seen Occupy come to life, and I was I'm not very up. I don't read the paper too much. It's sort of half depressing. I was thinking that it came to be that I heard of it, and then I just came to see it happen. And the people that are contributing to each other, it's sort of lifelike. It goes on its own, and like all the past speakers, like, this may be a dry run, but it's a proof of what people can do. And I also think that the media attention, if they spin it one way or the other, their attention, there's much other evils, and Occupy is just a bunch of people doing their own lives in front of them. And sometimes that can be troubling for them to see. So let them see more of that and Occupy. Continue.
Yeah! Never forget that a small group of thoughtful people can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has. Yeah! Let's do this!
Movement, so let's hear it for her.
Hi everybody, I'm really excited to see this many people. I'm one of the facilitators and administrators of the website and the Facebook, and it started with only 17 people when I joined the Facebook. And now we have over 225 members online and this many people out here. And and I'm going to keep it really short and simple, and I just want to say that this isn't our big event. This is just the beginning. We're going to be here for a long time until everybody knows what's going on and everyone is awake and conscious of what's happening in the world. And let's do the march!
Thank you.